Hello and welcome to Travel a la Mode exclusively on America West Airlines. Today, we're in Northern California. Now we're gonna do a little bit of shopping in Carmel, take a cooking class in Monterey, and show you the most convenient place to stay if you're doing business in San Jose. So sit back and relax as Travel a la Mode does Northern California. Thanks to an upturn in business travel and the economy, business has returned to San Jose. And the top choice for lodging? The Hyatt San Jose. Located a half mile from the airport, the Hyatt caters to travelers who come to do business in downtown San Jose and all over the Silicon Valley.
We consider ourselves less of a business hotel and more of a business resort. We're in a business area, but if you look at the grounds, it's a park-like setting. It's something you might expect to find in the Mediterranean or in Hawaii.
Hi.
How are
you doing today?
Doing great. How are you?
One thing that makes this property unique is the fact that the average tenure of the staff is an astounding 12 years.
It's nice to stay in a familiar place where people know you, where people know your likes and dislikes.
They surround you with lots of great artwork. There's a beautiful pool, and best of all, if you need to go downtown, there's a rail station right outside. And the trip only takes a few minutes. The Hyatt San Jose, always a pleasure to do business with. Our next stop is the exclusive enclave of Carmel by the Sea. There are more than 125 galleries here in Carmel by the Sea, which is a lot for a town of less than 5,000 people. Now, artists flocked here from nearby San Francisco after the 1906 quake. And can you blame them? It's full of inspiration. And speaking of inspiration, let's take a look at a local legend. Abstract painter Lindy B. Martin came to California from Germany in the 50s. Her organic forms and vibrant colors have made her gallery one of the most popular in town.
Every human being is creative. It's just that we learn very early on to make judgments. You have to learn not to be afraid of what happens. You have to give up control. And what you have to do is trust. Part of it is just having the experience, doing it every day. I'm going to go over this with a light yellow, thin light yellow, so that it comes through.
How truly fascinating. The art scene here in Carmel is one of the best, and the Lindy B. Martin Gallery is right at the top. At Gallery 21, you'll find quite a different perspective, surrealist landscapes and dreamlike atmospheres, all from the mind of American artist Ivan Durrell. Urged by his artist father to begin painting at age 10, Earl sold a painting to the Met by the time he was 24. He later worked for Disney doing production design for animated classics like Sleeping Beauty and Lady and the Tramp.
His father said, you have a choice, paint a painting a day or play the violin or guitar. He chose both. So Ivan was known for doing original serigraphs. A serigraph is a silkscreen printing. For every color, you have to do a color separation and you transfer to a screen and you print a color one at a time. Some painted that with 160, 200 colors. He was the father of design realism.
Ivan Durrell is one of America's most prolific and influential artists, and you'll find his work only in one place on the West Coast, right here at Gallery 21 in Carmel by the Sea. One of the hardest things to get while in Carmel is a tea time at nearby Pebble Beach. But time is never a problem at Carmel's premier purveyor of fine timepieces and exquisite estate jewelry, Greenwich Time. So Joseph, tell me about what I'm wearing here. Most importantly, if I wanted to take this home,
you could.
What would my credit card be charged?
This is $275,000.
Greenwich Time carries an extensive collection of diamond and estate jewelry, including one-of-a-kind necklaces, bracelets, and earrings.
Now I know why the movie stars do that, where they toss their hair because they're wearing these beautiful earrings.
They also feature the largest collection of watches in the area, like Audemars Piguet and IWC.
What makes a watch rare and expensive and fine.
They're extremely complicated and they take a very long time to make. If you look at the Scafusia, for example, it has a perpetual calendar, tourbillon, skeleton back.
Now, whether your idea of a splurge is $3,000 or $400,000, the experts are here to help. Greenwich Time, purveyors of fine timepieces and exquisite estate jewelry. Everywhere you look, magazines, runways, music videos, today's hottest fashion accessory is silver. And the hottest designer fueling the trend is Pat Arias, whose flagship store is right here in Carmel.
Every piece is cut with a jeweler's saw, hand hammered, hand soldered. I love fashion. I'm always watching the collections from Europe, what's happening in stones, color.
Their handcrafted belts are wearable works of art, each with its own unique design.
What could be more important than the center of your body?
Of course.
And what you're wearing in the middle should be even more important than the other.
Make sure you visit Pat Arias when in Northern California, but you can also check out her other stores in New York at the Aladdin in Las Vegas and her newest store in Beverly Hills. There's nothing I like more than a well-dressed man, and tops on our list is J. Lawrence Khakis, Clothier of Carmel. They're located in the world-renowned gardens of the Barnyard Shopping Village.
We take the time to really try to be a wardrobe specialist. I think that's probably the thing we do best. We're complimented on how the store looks, but I think we really try to design a wardrobe that's meant for each customer. We go from things like etro and striped shirts to more conservative things with Scott Barber and Robert Talbot. We just try to put together a pretty eclectic package. A lot of people would not put black with brown with gray with an intense tie like that. I think it's just a wonderful example of what we do really, really well.
Now, J. Lawrence Khakis is considered a best find by Playboy magazine. So whether you're looking for a weekend outfit or a formal suit, make sure you visit J. Lawrence Khakis next time you're at the Barnyard Shopping Village right here in Carmel. Good. Also located in the Barnyard Shopping District is a Carmel landmark, the ultra-popular Bahama Billy's. And this is a restaurant whose vibe is pure Caribbean fun. It's owned by local celebrity Billy Kwan and his wife Teresa, and it's known for tropical and vibrant Nouvelle.
We love the island feeling. We love the whole spirit of the islands. I've done a lot of Pacific Rim-style restaurants here on the beautiful Monterey Peninsula. This is the difference between a Bananas Foster and a Bananas Marley. Good Caribbean allspice and cinnamon.
Now, everything here is great, but my favorite was definitely the Caribbean Scampi, Bananas Marley, and of course, Jason's famous meatloaf. Oh, thank you so much. Look at this. Delicious. And this is what makes Bahama Billy's so wonderful. It's the delicious food and the atmosphere. And of course, you have to watch for Billy's new restaurant, the Bixby Martini, which opens in spring 2005. And right next door, there's Billy's Art and Gift Gallery. Also a great place you gotta check out. Next time you're in Carmel, you have to take at least one day to visit nearby Monterey. Monterey is known for its spectacular setting and its great California cuisine. And it's home to the Culinary Center of Monterey, founded in 1998 by Mary Pagan.
So we're gonna put a light amount of oil in here. We do a lot of corporate team building. We do a lot of classes for the general public. We also have a 1,400-hour, 8-month vocational program for people who wanna be chefs. And it's really designed to teach people how to be successful in the industry. A huge part of our business is corporate team building. People come into the kitchen to cook together and then sit down and eat together. We do so many nationally recognized events here that if people can learn to work in this environment and be successful here on the Monterey Peninsula, then they could probably be successful in the restaurant industry anywhere.
Now, the Culinary Center of Monterey offers one-day classes, corporate team-building events, and even kids' cooking classes. And they have great recipes like high protein and low carb. And usually, they don't even make you do the dishes. Well, that's it for this edition of Travel a la Mode. Hope you enjoyed our trip through Northern California.
Now make sure you join us next time when you fly America West Airlines. I'm Kinga Phillips. Thanks for watching.